I pray thee, good Mercutio, let's retire. The day is hot, the Capulet's abroad, and if we meet, we shall not scape a brawl. For now, these hot days, is the mad blood stirring.
Thou art like one of those fellows that, when he enters the confines of a tavern, claps me his sword upon the table and says, God send me no need of thee. And by the operation of the second cup, draws it on the drawer when indeed there is no need.
Am I like such a fellow?
Come, come, thou art as hot a jack in thy mood as any in Italy, and as soon moved to be moody, and as soon moody to be moved.
And what to?
Nay, and there were two as such, we should have none shortly, for one would kill the other. Thou, why, thou wilt quarrel with a man that hath a hair more or a hair less in his beard than thou hast. Thou wilt quarrel with a man for cracking nuts, having no other reason, but because thou hast hazel eyes. What eye but such an eye would spy out such a quarrel? Thy head is as full of quarrels as an egg is full of meat, and yet thy head has been beaten as addle as an egg for quarreling. Thou hast quarreled with a man for coughing in the street because he hath awakened thy dog that hath lain asleep in the sun. Didst thou not quarrel with a tailor for wearing his new doublet before Easter? With another for tying his new shoes with old ribbon? And thou wilt tutor me from quarreling.
And I were so apt to quarrel as thou art, any man should buy the fee simple of my life for an hour and a quarter.
The fee simple? Oh, simple.
By my head, here come the Capulets.
By my heel, I care not.
Tybalt, dost thou believe that they know of our coming?
They know, they know, they know. Yeah, they know.
Follow me close, for I will speak to them.
Gentlemen, good evening. A word with one of you.
And but one word with one of us? Couple it with something. Make it a word and a...
You shall find me apt enough to that, sir, and you shall give me occasion.
Could you not take some occasion without giving?
Mercutio, thou consortst with Romeo.
Consort? What, dost thou make us minstrels? And thou make minstrels of us, look to hear nothing but discords.
Here is my fiddlestick. Here's that shall make you dance.
Zounds, consort.
Hello there.
We talk here in the public haunt of men.
Either withdraw one to some private place and reason coldly of your grievances, or else depart.
Here, all eyes gaze on us.
Who's watching? Tell me who's watching?
Men's eyes were made to look, and let them gaze. I will not budge for no man's pleasure, I.
Well, peace be with you, sir. Here comes my man.
Here comes your man. Here comes your man. Here comes your man.
But I'll be hanged, sir, if he wear your livery. Marry, go before to field, and he'll be your follower. Your worship in that sense may call him man.
Romeo, the love I bear thee can afford no better term than this. Thou art a villain!
Tybalt, the reason that I have to love thee doth much excuse the appertaining rage to such a greeting. Therefore, farewell. I see thou knowest me not.
Baby, you don't know a thing about me.
Boy, this shall not excuse the injuries that thou hast done me. Therefore, turn and draw.
I do protest I never injured thee, but love thee more than thou canst devise, till thou shalt know the reason of my love. And so, good Capulet, which name I tender as dearly as my own, be satisfied.
Oh, calm, dishonorable, vile submission. A la staccata carries it away.
Take on me.
Take on me.
stature. Will you walk? What wouldst thou have with me? Good king of cats, nothing but one of your 9 lives that I mean to make bold withal. And as you shall use me hereafter, dry beat the rest of the 8. Will you pluck your sword out of his pilcher by the ears? Make haste, lest mine be about your ears, ere it be out. I am for you!
Come on at me, bro. Come on at me, bro.
Gentle Mercutio, put thy rapier up.
Come, sir, your passado!
Draw, Benvolio, beat down their weapons.
Gentlemen, for shame, forbear this outrage. Tybalt, Mercutio, the prince hath expressly forbidden bandying in Verona streets. Hold, Tybalt, good Mercutio! Tybalt.
Leg out.
I am hurt. A plague on both of your houses. Is he gone and hath nothing?
You've been hit by a smooth criminal.
What, art thou hurt?
Aye. A scratch. Mary, 'tis enough. Where's my page? Go, villain! Fetch a surgeon!
Courage, man. The hurt cannot be much.
No. 'Tis not so deep as a well, nor so wide as a church door. But 'tis enough. 'Twill serve. Ask for me tomorrow, and you shall find me a grave man. I am peppered, I warrant, for this world. A dog, a rat, a mouse, a cat to scratch a man to death. A braggart, a rogue, a villain that fights by the book of arithmetic. Why the devil came you between us? I was hurt under your arm.
I thought all for the best.
Help me into some house, Benvolio, or I shall faint. A plague on both your houses. They have made worm's meat of me. I have it, and soundly too. Your houses!
Mercutio, I am so very sorry.
It's too late to apologize. It's too late.
This gentleman, the prince's near ally, my very friend, hath got his mortal hurt on my behalf, my reputation stained with Tybalt's slander. Tybalt, that an hour hath been my kinsman. Oh, Juliet, thy beauty hath made me effeminate, and in my temper softened valor's steel.
Romeo, Romeo, brave Mercutio is dead.
That gallant spirit hath aspired the clouds which too untimely here did scorn the earth.
This day's black fate on more days doth depend. This but begins the woe that others must end.
Here comes the furious Tybalt back again,
alive in triumph. And Mercutio slain. Away to heaven, respective lenity, and fire-eyed fury be my conduct now. Now, Tybalt, take the villain back again that late thou gavest me, for Mercutio's soul is but a little way above our heads, staying for thine to keep him company. Either thou or I, or both, must go with him. Thou wretched boy that didst consort him here shall with him hence. This shall determine that.
Last name ever, first name greatest. Like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with.
Romeo, away, be gone! The citizens are up, and Tybalt slain. Stand not amazed, the prince will doom thee death if thou art taken. Hence, be gone, away! Oh, I am fortune's fool!
What are you waiting for?
Which way ran he that killed Mercutio? Tybalt, that murderer. Which way ran he?
So they're right.
There lies Tybalt.
Up, sir. Go with me. I charge you in the prince's name. Obey!
Where are the vile beginners of this fray? Oh, noble prince, I can discover all the unlucky manage of this fatal brawl. There lies the man slain by a young Romeo, who slew thy kinsman, brave Mercutio.
Tybalt! Tybalt.
He cannot possibly be dead.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out.
Tybalt, my cousin. Oh, my brother's child. Oh, prince. Oh, cousin, husband! Oh, the blood is spilled of my dear kinsman. Prince, as thou art true, for blood of ours shed blood of Montague. Oh, cousin, cousin!
Benvolio, who began this bloody fray? Tybalt, he is slain, whom Romeo's hand did slay. Romeo, that spoke him fair, bade him bethink how nice the quarrel was, and urged withal your high displeasure. All this uttered with gentle breath, calm look, knees humbly bowed, could not take truce with the unruly spleen of Tybalt, deaf to peace, but that he tilts with piercing steel at bold Mercutio's breast, who, all this hot, turns deadly point to point. And with a martial scorn with one hand, beats cold death aside, and with the other sends it back to Tybalt, whose dexterity retorts it. Romeo, he cries aloud, hold, friends, friends part!
Why can't we be friends?
And swifter than his tongue, his agile arm beats down their fatal points, and twixt them rushes, underneath whose arm an envious thrust from Tybalt hit the life of stout Mercutio. And then Tybalt fled. But by and by comes back to Romeo, who had but newly entertained revenge, and to it they go like lightning, for ere I could draw to part them was stout Tybalt slain, and as he fell did Romeo turn and fly. This is the truth, or let Benvolio die.
He is a kinsman to the Montague. Affection makes him false, he speaks not true. Some 20 of them fought in this black strife, and all those 20 could but kill one life. I beg for justice, which thou, prince, must give. Romeo slew Tybalt. Romeo must not live.
Romeo slew him, he slew Mercutio. Who now the price of his dear blood doth owe?
Not Romeo, prince, he was Mercutio's friend. His fault concludes but what the law should end, the life of Tybalt.
And for that offense, immediately we do exile him hence. I have an interest in your heart's proceeding.
My heart's a stereo.
My blood for your rude brawls doth lie a-bleeding. But I'll immerse you with so strong a fine, you'll all repent the loss of mine. I will be deaf to pleading and excuses. Nor tears, nor prayers shall purchase out abuses. Therefore use none. Let Romeo hence in haste, else when he's found, that hour is his last. Bear hence this body and attend our will. Mercy but murders, pardoning those that kill.
Stereo, it beats for you, so listen close. Hear my thoughts in every note. Make me
Nothing was meant for you. So sing along to my stereo.
You class heroes, baby. If I was just another dusty record on the shelf, would you blow me off and play me like everybody else? If I asked you to scratch my back, could you manage that? Like it, yeah.